हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फोर्थ सेशन ऑफ थर्ड यूनिट, ब्रूट फोर्स एंड एग्जॉस्टिव सर्च। द कोर्स आउटकम विल बी डिस्कसिंग द वेरियस ब्रूट फोर्स टेक्निक्स। इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस वेरी फेमिलियर प्रॉब्लम, दैट इज लीनियर सर्च अल्गोरिदम। A linear search is a brute force strategy used for searching a key in a given array. So, for a given array, we search a key whether it is present in the array or not. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅರೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಅರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕೀ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅಥವಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಎ ಕೀ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರೇ. ಇಫ್ ದ ಕೀ ಇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅರೇ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ the search is unsuccessful. So what will be the outcome of this algorithm? Either successful search or unsuccessful search. So now let us go through the algorithm. Name of the algorithm is linear search, where an array is passed and a search key. These two parameters are passed to the linear search algorithm. It searches a given value in a given array by sequential search technique. And what are the inputs given to this algorithm? An array of size n and a search key say k. And what will be the output of this algorithm? This algorithm returns the index of the first element in A, that is in array, that matches with K. ಯಾವ ಒಂದು ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೀಗೆ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಆ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಈ ಅಲ್ಗೋರಿದಮ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಕೀ does not matching with any of the array element, then what it returns? It returns -1. That means unsuccessful. Now let us see the logic of this algorithm. We initialize I equal to 0 and we use while loop. Here we use two expressions. First one is we compare I with the size of the array, that is n, whether I is less than n, and if A of I is not equal to k, if these two conditions are satisfied, then enter into the loop and increment the value of I by 1. Okay, so if any of the condition fails, then control comes out of the loop and we check whether I is less than n. If yes, then return the value of the index. Otherwise, return the -1 value, that is unsuccessful search. This is the logic of the algorithm. Now let us see the flowchart of this algorithm. So start the algorithm, initialize I equal to 0 and compare I with the length of the array. Here len length indicates the size of the array. If I is less than length of the array, then again compare the ith position value with the key. Right, So if I is less than length of the array, then return minus 1. If it is matching with the given key, then return the index value or index of the current matching element. And increment I by 1 and repeat it. So this is the flowchart of the linear search algorithm. So here is an implementation of the linear search in C language. Here I have taken a C program which implements the linear search algorithm. So here it's the main function, int void main. Here I am taking an array which is having the values 2, 3, 4, 10 and 40, and x equal to 10. Here my key value is 10, or for your clarity I write here k equal to 10 and result, and n equal to size of array. Here I am using inbuilt function size of, which calculates the size of the array, and that is assigned to the variable n, which represents the size of the array. After this initialization, here I am calling the function called search, and what I am passing to this search function, I am passing the entire array, size of the array and the key which is to be searched in the array. Okay, so come back here. Here it is my search function. Int I equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus. For the implementation of this algorithm, I am using for loop, and here I am comparing whether a of array of I is equal to x or k. If so, then return I. Otherwise, if none of the elements of the array are matching with k, then return minus 1. So now compare the variable result with the minus 1. If it is minus 1, then printf element is not present in array, else element is present at index result. Now whatever the index value is returned, that will be printed here. Understood, students? So now let us see this algorithm with the help of example. Here an example which consists of the elements 17, 29, 34, 45, 68, 90, 96, and 100. Totally there are 8 elements and my search key is 90. So 90 is to be searched in the given array. Okay. So here it is comparing 90 with the first value of the array or first index value of the array. Whether 90 is equal to 17, no. Then what to do if it is not equal to the key value? Then simply increment the I value. So again, search key 90 is compared with the A of 1th position, which is 29. Hence, 90 is not equal to 29. Increment I value, I plus plus. Next, compare 90 with the 34. Right, so here also there is no matching. Then next, increment the I value, I plus plus, which becomes 3. Compare this search key 90 with the present ith position, which is whose value is 45. Again there is no match. Hence increment the I value. Again compare 90 with the 68. There is no matching, hence I plus plus, which will become the 5. Now compare the search key with the present ith indexing value, which is 90. Hence 90 is equal to 90. So the search key is present in the given array at the position 5. Hence key found at A of 5 position. Okay students, so this is how the linear search works. Now let us discuss the time complexity of the algorithm. Let us analyze the algorithm. So basically, what are the points to be considered while analyzing an algorithm? First, we have to consider the size of the algorithm and the basic operation, that is determining the output of the algorithm. We have to consider that also. Along with that, how many number of times the basic operation is being executed, right? So these all points we discussed in second unit. So just I am recapping those points here. So in this case, there are three cases to analyze the time complexity of the algorithm. We have to go through the three cases. What are those cases? Case number one. If the key is matched with the first element of the array, then the time complexity will lie in the best case. We say the time complexity of the algorithm is best case, and we represent best case efficiency of an algorithm with the help of big omega notation. Okay, so hence T of n will be big omega of 1. You can represent big O also instead of big omega. Here I have taken big omega. So this is the case number one. Let us discuss the case two. If the element is searched through the array and it is matched to the last element of the array, or it might not match with any of the elements. So let us consider, you know, patanta search key last element in the array do aa positionally present ittantandre athwa present iradeno ittantandre avaga naavu yav cases anna consider martivi. We will consider the worst case efficiency of the algorithm, and worst case efficiency is represented by what we usually represent that with the help of big O notation. And in worst case, what is the definition of worst case? It is the maximum number of steps taken to execute the algorithm. And here the maximum number of steps will become the size of the array. Hence, we can say the worst case efficiency of the linear search algorithm will be big O of n. Understood, students? Now let us go through the third case. Third case is, if element is matched in between these two positions, that is average case. So an average case efficiency lies between the best case and the worst case. So in this present scenario, if the element is matched in between these two positions, then time complexity will be average case and is represented using big theta notation. Average case efficiency now yavudrilinda represent martivi, big theta notation lin represent martivi. So average case lies between best case and worst case, and it will be a linear function. So average case, best case now notidvi big omega of 1, worst case en notidvi big O of n. So ivu eradru nadave enagutte average case annu barutte. So average number of comparisons made by the algorithm is n plus 1 by 2. So this is a general formula. Okay, so removing the constant terms, you will get big O of n. Hence the average case of the linear search is big O of n. Okay students, so this is about time complexity of the linear search. Next, let us see the simulation part of the linear search. So how algorithm works over a given array along with the given key. Okay students, now let us see the simulation of linear search algorithm. So here it is an array which consists of unordered elements, that is 94, 65, 27, 88, 61, 71, 16, 92, 81, and 41. So here are the symbols, colored symbols. You can see a green circle. What it represents? It represents the current element. A black circle represents the element is found in the array. What the red circle represents? It represents element not found. So during simulation, these things you have to observe. So what it is asking? It is asking user here enter a number to be searched. So here you have to enter the number which is to be searched in the given array. So let us enter the key and let's check whether it is present in the array or not. So let me enter the key, say 50, and here I am, press the start button. So it is checking 94, 65. Green symbol represents the current element or where the current position of the controller. So here it is checking 92, 81, 41, and 50 is not present in the given array. It is not present anywhere. So what is the message? The element 50 was not found in the array. Okay students, so here you can say the worst case efficiency of the algorithm. So in worst case, the element may be present at the last position of the array or it may not be present. So in this present case, our 50 element is not present in the array. So let me reset this once again and let us see the best case. So best case is what? If the search key is present at the first position of the array itself, then it is a best case. So let me enter the value 12 and let me start the search. 12 is present, hence a black color is shaded. The element 12 was found in the zeroth position of the array. So the algorithm returns the position of the element where it is matching. Okay, so let me reset once again and let me find the another element, say 83. So it is searching now, and 83 is present at the 8th position of the array. So once again, let me reset and try to find another element, say the last element, which is 54, and start the searching. So it searches for the element 54, and now let us check what it will give the message. 91 63 98 51, current index, which is 8, and finally the element 54 was found in the 9th position of the array, which is also a worst case. So if the search key lies between the best case and the worst case, then we say it is average case. Let me enter the search key, say 43, and start it. So it is searching. So here the basic operation is comparison. The key 43 is comparing with the every element of the array. Now the element 43 was found in the 5th position of the array. Okay students, now we have seen the simulation of the linear search algorithm, how it works. Next we will see the C program execution. We will implement the code which we have seen in the above slides. Okay students, let us implement the linear search algorithm through C language. Here it is my C program editor come compiler. So you can implement the algorithm statically or dynamically. Statically means you are taking the array elements in advance, and also you are specifying the search key. Whereas dynamically means after execution of the program, you are asking users dynamically to enter the array elements as well as search key. So let me implement this linear search dynamically. Int array, say, and a key value, say k, and we need to specify the size of the array, say n, and one variable, say I, and ask the user printf enter the size of the array. Okay students, so you have to enter the size of the array, %d, ampersand of n. For size of the array, I have taken the n as the size indicator. Next, once you specified the size of the array, next we have to enter the array elements. Array elements. For that, you have to use for loop. For I equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus, scanf, percent of d, ampersand of array of I. So which accepts the user elements. Now after entering the array elements, you can also display the array. Printf entered array elements. Entered array elements are so again you can use the for loop. For I equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus, and printf percent d of t delimiter. I am here using t as tab and array I, which displays the array elements. Okay, students. Now let me ask the user to enter the search key which user wants to search. Enter the search key. Okay, students. Scanf percent d comma ampersand k. I have taken the k variable for specifying the search key. Next, call the function say search. So here let me call the function say search. Result equal to search. What I am passing to the function search? The array, size of the array, and the search key. Next, if result is equal to minus 1, then print the message as unsuccessful search. Else print the message successful search, or you can print it as search key found at the position percent d comma result. Okay, next let me write the search function outside the main function. So int search int array comma int n comma int key, and Here, let me take one local variable, say I, and for I equal to 0, comma, I is less than n, comma, I plus plus, and check whether if A of I is equal to k, that is present index value of the array, if it is equal to the search key k, then return what to return? The index of the matching value, right? Else return minus 1. Okay, students. Now let me run this program. So here I edited the entire code. Now I am running this code. Run. So the console is asking the user to enter the size of the array. So let me enter the size of the array be 5. Enter. Enter the array elements. So let me write, or let me enter the array elements as say 20, 30, 24, 50, 84. Okay. So after entering the elements, it is displaying entered array elements are. It should be entered array elements are. So 20, 30, 24, 50, 84. Next, enter the search key. So here I will enter the search key, say 24. So let me check whether this element is present in the entered array or not. So here is the output. Search key found at the position 2. So here you can check at the 0th position 20 is present, 1 position 30 is present, and at that second position 24 is present. Hence there is a successful search, right? So you can check once again for unsuccessful search case. So let me enter once again the size of the array be 5 and enter the array elements say 20, 10, 24, 45, say 75. Enter array 20, 10, 24, 45 and 75. I enter the search key. So here let me enter a key say 90, which is not present in the entered array, and it should give unsuccessful search. So here it is the output, unsuccessful search. Okay, students. So this is the implementation of C program, that is linear search through C program. Okay, students. So in this session, we discussed about linear search algorithm, its flowchart, and its working through an example. Also, we have seen the simulation of this linear search algorithm. And at last, we discussed the program implementation through C language. Okay, students. So here it is the reference for your kind information. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you once again.